This video will show you how to use the PGP feature of Control-Info File Transfer. Control-Info Advanced File Transfer, or AFT, supports encrypting and decrypting files using the PGP or GNU-PG applications. AFT does not come with this encryption technology built in as part of the product. AFT runs external PGP or GPG commands, which must already be installed and configured. The transfer direction, upload or download, implies whether the file will be encrypted or decrypted. Here we have two machines, on one of which AFT is installed, and the other is the FTP server to which we will up or download files. If AFT downloads a file from the FTP server, it can decrypt the file afterwards. And when AFT uploads a file, it can encrypt before sending it. AFT cannot run the PGP commands on a remote FTP server. Therefore, when transferring between two remote FTP servers, the PGP option cannot be used. One of the two hosts used in the transfer must be the local AFT machine. Here I am logged into two machines. On the left is my AFT machine, where I am logged in as the V900P user. On the right is the remote SFTP server. I've placed plain text files on both machines, which I will use for the GPG encryption. We'll now need to define a PGP template, so we'll go to the AFTCM, right-click and select Template Management. Two skeleton templates already come with the product, and since I'll be using GPG, I'll copy the GNU-PG template to create a new one. It will need a name. The full path to the GPG binary, and the passphrase so it can access the user's private key when decrypting, and the recipient to which we'll be sending our encrypted files. Finally, we see the encryption and decryption command line parameters that AFT will pass to the GPG binary when running it. If for any reason you have a version of these applications that require a slightly different parameter, you can change them here. Now I'll have a quick look at the connection profile. I already have a connection profile for transferring files between these two hosts. Note again that one of them is the local host and the other one is the remote host. In the connection profile itself, there are no specific GPG features. We know this profile works, so we can continue to define our job. So we're in the GUI planning domain, and now I'll create a file transfer job. Then select the connection profile, which we just looked at. This is it. Okay. Select the file that we're gonna encrypt and upload. This is the one. And the target directory, that's the correct one. Okay. And then click Advanced. And on the Commands tab, there is the Enable PGP Encryption option. So we enable that. And here we can select the template name which we wanted to use. So that's this one. And then there's the additional option to keep the encrypted files. So this is used if you download a file and AFT decrypts it. If you have this option enabled, it'll also keep the encrypted files. So click OK. And we're ready to order the job. There we go. Let's switch to monitoring. And we can see the job just finished. It ended OK. Let's look at the output. We can see transfer starting, and here the PGP command is that we defined is being executed. So we can see it's running the GPG command with all the parameters, the recipient. So let's see on our destination system if the file was actually uploaded. Yeah, there it is. So let's see what that file actually looks like. It should be encrypted. Yeah, this is where normally readable ASCII would be, but this is just complete gibberish. So that looks encrypted enough. Let's see if we can decrypt it. And there you go. There's the original file again. Now I'll do the reverse. I'll encrypt a file on the remote SFTP server, then let AFT download and decrypt it automatically. So I've got the file here. I'll encrypt it with the user here. So the recipient will be the local user on the AFT machine. And I'll encrypt this file. Here we've got the encrypted version of the file. Let's see if that's actually encrypted. Should be. Yep, that looks encrypted. So let's define a job for AFT to download that file. So here is the GUI again. Check out my workspace. Add a file transfer job. Call it GPG download. Use the same connection profile and change the transfer direction. On the target machine, select the encrypted file. Enable PGP encryption again. Select our PGP template and we'll keep the option disabled. And we're ready to order the job. Go back to monitoring, download job, let's have a look at the output. We can see it transferred the file first and then ran an execute PGP command with the decrypt option. So let's have a look what we'll find on our local machine here. There's this file and it's been decrypted. We can see our beautiful painting by Vermeer again. So that's it. That concludes this Contralim Solutions video. Visit our YouTube channel for more.